Welcome, everyone, to San Manuel Stadium, home of the Inland Empire 66ers for the first county clash of the high school baseball season here in 2024. Coming up here live on IEMG, we've got Citrus Valley taking on Cajon in a key Citrus Belt League battle. That's coming up live on IEMG, and it starts right now. Greetings, everybody. Welcome to San Manuel Stadium for the County Clash. Cajon taking on Citrus Valley. I can't help but laugh when Bernie gets on the field. You can see him down there on the IE 66ers logo. Yes, it's that time of the year. It's a little cold. It's a little wet. We had some rain in the game previous to this one. It was a 1 o'clock first pitch for Redlands and Yucaipa with a little bit of drizzle throughout the entire game, but they got it in, and it was Yucaipa winning by a score of 3-2-0. Yeah, those clouds. This is over in the mountains. This is like looking beyond downtown San Bernardino up into the mountains. I guess that'd probably be Big Bear-ish that way. And, yeah, you can still see the mountains or still see the clouds on top of the mountains there. So I don't know if we're quite out of the woods yet, but I do see a little bit of blue skies peeking through here at San Manuel Stadium. Well, as I mentioned, Yucaipa beat Redlands High School 3-0 in the first game of the county clash here on this afternoon. And coming up, we've got Citrus Valley and Cajon, which we have live for you guys here on IEMG. And then a little bit later tonight, 7 o'clock first pitch, it will be Redlands East Valley and Beaumont. So the first county clash of the season here at San Manuel Stadium. All Citrus Belt League, wall-to-wall CBL games all day here on this Saturday. And I hope you'll come back to IEMG this upcoming week because we have a very special Sports Weekly that we're filming out here at San Manuel Stadium for the County Clash. So I hope you guys will check in with that. We're going to have other high school baseball and softball highlights. And we're going to have actually an exclusive interview with a basketball star from Aquinas. So we got a lot of cool things coming up here on Sports Weekly. It'll be a very special Sports Weekly from San Manuel Stadium, the County Clash. There's a look at the field. The Blackhawks and the Cowboys were just out there warming up, and they'll be out there again shortly as we get ready for first pitch, which is scheduled for 4 p.m. And it looks like we're running about on time here. They do such a great job here at San Manuel Stadium, especially with all things considered with the weather. It's a little dicey to keep this field ready, and I mean, three games in one day, it's hard enough to get prepped for one game, let alone three in a row with rain. But as I mentioned, right now, the field looks great. There is no rain right now. It's a little cold and overcast, but I think we're going to be okay for this one, hopefully, fingers crossed. And then later tonight, Redlands East Valley taking on Beaumont. That will be the nightcap. Cajon warming up, getting set for first pitch in just about 10 minutes. The Cowboys enter the game with a record of 5-4 overall, 1-1 in the CBL. And for Citrus Valley, they check in at 7-5 overall, 2-2 in the CBL. So we just wanted to make sure you guys found the correct live stream. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a very quick break here on IEMG. Now that you're in the right spot, you're watching us live here on IEMG, keep it right here. We're going to play a couple of commercials, and when we come back, it'll be just about time for first pitch here at San Manuel Stadium between Cajon and Citrus Valley in CBL action. My name is Pep Fernandez, and we will be right back.
Hey friend, you over there, gather around, because I've got the inside scoop on this incredible and all-inclusive program that's taking San Bernardino by storm. It's the Back to Nature program. This fantastic nature program is funded by the Outdoor Equity Grant Program created through AB 209 and administered by California State Parks Office of Grants and Local Services. It's designed to take community members of all ages, from youth to teens, seniors, and entire families on unforgettable adventures in nature. Picture this: overnight camping escapades at YMCA Camp Elk for the youth, a family camping trip under the stars at Silverwood Lake, a specially curated winter camping experience for individuals with disabilities in the mountains at Lake Arrowhead, and even an overnight beach camping extravaganza at Leo Carrillo State Beach. But wait, there's more. Day trips that'll have you hiking to the mesmerizing waterfalls of Etiwanda Nature Reserve or the top of Mount Rubidoux and soaking in the wonders of SeaWorld San Diego. And that's not all. We've got the Back to Nature Club, where youth can come together and make a difference in their community and champion environmental justice through cool activities like community cleanups and more. So if you're itching for some fun, looking to make a positive impact, or just want to soak up the beauty of nature, the Back to Nature program is where it's at. For all the info on how to join in on these amazing activities, you can call me, Ms. Trina, at 909-601-1566 or email me at shelton-moore_tr@svcity.org. Hey friends, guess what? Back to Nature is now registering for overnight camp at YMCA Camp Elk. Youth ages 7 to 12 will attend camp from June 10th to June 14th. Teenagers 13 to 17 will attend camp from June 24th to 28th. You don't want to miss out on all the fun. There will be archery, rock wall climbing, improv, arts and crafts, swimming, campfires, and stargazing. This program is funded by the Outdoor Equity Grant Program, created through AB 209 and administered by California State Parks Office of Grants and Local Services. For all the information on how to join in on the fun, you can call me, Ms. Trina, at 909-601-1566 or email me at shelton-moore_tr@svcity.org. Space is limited, so register now.
Bernardino has implemented a new low-cost sidewalk vending program in hopes of expanding opportunity for community members to start sidewalk vending safely and lawfully. We want everyone to have access to the economic benefits that sidewalk vending brings, but we want to make sure that our sidewalk vendors know the do's and don'ts when it comes to our city. We must make sure that vendors are keeping our residents safe by following general health and safety standards, and by following all city rules. Like, did you know to legally sidewalk bend in the city of San Bernardino, you'll need a seller's permit? What about the $1 million general liability insurance that you are required to have? Don't let this scare you. When all is said and done, the cost of the annual permit will either be $64 or $154. We want to help in every way we can when it comes to vendors lawfully running and growing their small businesses. But those who operate without the proper permits can and will be cited. Citations can run anywhere from $100 to a misdemeanor, and repeated violations can result in the confiscation of items needed to sidewalk vend. We do not want this to be you. So if you have any questions or concerns regarding the new sidewalk vending program, please call us at 909-384-5035, where staff will help you navigate your way to becoming a safe and permitted vendor in our city.
Now that school is back in session, the San Bernardino Public Library is supporting online learners in a couple of ways. With BrainFuse Live Homework Help, BrainFuse offers kindergarten through grade 12, college and adult learners assistance with various subjects. Experts via live chat from 1 p.m. to 10 p.m. daily, except major holidays. BrainFuse can be accessed through the library's website at www.sbpl.org. BrainFuse offers help with SATs, ACTs, and GED test prep. A writing lab is also available. BrainFuse is also available in Spanish. You will need a San Bernardino Public Library card to log in. If you do not already have one, you can sign up online for a free library card at the library's website at www.sbpl.org, or go directly to http://catalog.sbpl.org:8086/online-borrower-registration.html. Please allow up to a full working day for your library card to be activated.
The head coach of the Blackhawks is John Austin. Assistant coach Billy Rainbow. Assistant coach Joey Carr. Assistant coach Gary Tessitore.
Welcome back, everybody. The teams being introduced here at San Manuel Stadium for the County Clash. That's Citrus Valley in the gold uniforms. The Cajon Cowboys will be the home team for this one. They'll be coming out in just a moment in the home white uniform. So we'll take a quick pause right here and check in with the PA announcer as the Cowboys take the field. And welcome back, everybody. Getting close to first pitch here between the Blackhawks and Cajon. I misspoke earlier when I was mentioning Citrus Valley's record. I was looking at the CBL standings and looking at a bunch of teams at once. Citrus Valley 5-5 overall, 0-2 in the CBL, so still very young in this league portion of the season. But Cajon 5-4, 1-1 overall. Getting the ball for Cajon will be Isaac Fabella. He'll be on the bump. This one, he's getting the start here for head coach Robert Grande and the Cowboys. We appreciate you tuning in live on IEMG as we get settled in as well. Cajon, the home team for this one, so they're in the 66ers dugout. The Blackhawks in the visiting gold uniforms. Should be a fun one here on IEMG. It's always fun to bring you guys CBL action. And this year, maybe more so than years past, the CBL is going to be a wide open race for that league title. I think every single team in the league feels like they've got a chance to compete for the league title and challenge for one of those top three spots, which are automatic bids to the playoffs. As we mentioned earlier, Yucaipa getting the best of Redlands by a score of 3-0. Tonight it'll be Rev and Beaumont to cap things off, the first county clash of the season. And we are about ready to go. Looks like Isaac Fabella ready to take the bump and do this. There's the first pitch from Fabella. It's going to miss in for a ball. Angel Perez for the Blackhawks leading things off here in the top of the first. That one's in for a strike. 1-1 the count. There's Perez. The pitch to Perez. That one gets away. 2-1 the count. The offering from Fabella. Driven deep to right field. Caught, and there's your first out of the game. Perez drives it deep to right, but one down here for the Cowboys. Out for the Blackhawks, number 3, Keaton Nadeau. Nadeau, the son of Mike Nadeau, the head baseball coach at Cal State San Bernardino. We've seen him plenty of times on Sports Weekly on IEMG, of course, right? So we're going to miss. 1-1 the count. That one hit to the right side. Good play over at first. Number 20 for the Cowboys, Matt Basurto. That'll bring up the three hitter for the Blackhawks, Matt Bline. First pitch from Fabella in for a ball. 1-0 the count. That one's in for a strike. Evens it 1-1. That one's going to miss. 2-1 the count. Three and one to Blind. Blind stepping in from the left side for the Blackhawks. Three and one the count. You can imagine he's got the green light here. That one's going to miss. Blind will take his free pass to first. And the Blackhawks have a runner aboard here with two outs in the top of the first inning. That'll bring up Robert Seeley, the cleanup hitter for Citrus Valley. He's got a runner on board. First pitch to Seeley. He's in for a strike. Catches the outside. Swing and a miss. 0-2 the count now to Seeley. Fabella one strike away from getting his team back in the dugout. Send this one to the bottom of the first. The pitch outside. Fabella on the mound. Seeley at the dish. 1-2. The runner goes and fouled away. And up and out of the park. One and two, the count to Robert Seeley. Throw back to first. Keeping an eye on Matt Blind over there at first. Back over to first. That one's going to be called strike three for Fabella. Closes out the top of the first inning with his first K of the game. So now we move to the bottom of the first. No score between the Cowboys and the Blackhawks on IEMG. We will take a quick break, and we'll be right back.
Join us for our weekly Farmers Market in San Bernardino. The Farmers Market is ongoing every Tuesday at Court Street Square, located at 349 Northeast Street from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. This event features both farmers and hot food vendors. Come purchase fresh produce at the Farmers Market and enjoy a nutritious lunch for the day. This is a certified Farmers Market with fresh and quality produce grown by real farmers from the region. For more information, visit our website at sbcity.org/parks. You can also call us at 909-384-5233 or email us at recreation@sbcity.org. See you there.
And welcome back to the County Clash, San Manuel Stadium, Blackhawks and Cowboys. Cade Finazzo getting the start here for head coach John Austin and the Blackhawks. Head coach Robert Grande on the opposite side, getting his team ready to go. There's Coach Grande posted up just on the edge of the dugout. Just about ready to begin the bottom of the first inning here at San Manuel Stadium. Our first county clash of the year. We've got another one coming up on March 30th and then again on April 13th. Leading things off for the Cowboys, number 27, Dominic Reinbolt. First pitch to Reinbolt from Finazzo, in for a ball. 1-0 the count. That one fouled straight back. One and one in the count to Reinbolt. That one popped up. And getting underneath it is Finazzo for the first out here in the bottom of the first. Finazzo taking matters into his own hands for out number one. So one down here in the bottom of the first inning. That'll bring up number 12, Gavin Garcia. Garcia looks at the first offering, in for a ball. Garcia does have a home run on the season, so he's got some power. Oh, and speaking of, drills it deep to right center field, but going back on it. Hit very hard, but tracking it down, the center fielder for Citrus Valley, and there's out number two. That'll bring up number 15, Ryan Contreras. Leading Cajon with a batting average of .444 and 12 hits. He's got 13 RBI on the year. Contreras fouls that one off. The weather cooperating right now here at San Manuel Stadium, so we get these baseball games in, which we're all excited about. That one into Contreras. 3-1 the count. Hitters count for Contreras. We'll see if he's got the green light. Looks at that one, takes ball four. So Contreras heads down to first. That'll bring up Marcus McQueen, power hitter for the Cowboys. First pitch, McQueen is in for a ball from Finazzo. Want to know the count. That one also in for a ball. 2-0 to McQueen. McQueen's brother was a big-time baseball player as well just a couple years ago. That one's fouled back into the right. Who can forget that C.V. Cajon CIF Southern Section Championship game that we had a couple years ago coming out of COVID? That one fouled on the right side, giving chase, but that one's also going to find foul ground and into the stands. Good hustle there by John McKee over at first base. 2-2 to McQueen. Big strike three. So Finazzo ends the first with a K. Fabella ended the top of the first with a K. So the pitchers looking strong early on here at the County Clash. We'll take a quick break here on IEMG. Then it's right back to San Manuel Stadium for the second inning.
Hey friends, guess what? Back to Nature is now registering for overnight camp at YMCA Camp Elk. Youth ages 7 to 12 will attend camp from June 10th to June 14th. Teenagers 13 to 17 will attend camp from June 24th to 28th. You don't want to miss out on all the fun. There will be archery, rock wall climbing, improv, arts and crafts, swimming, campfires, and stargazing. This program is funded by the Outdoor Equity Grant Program, created through AB 209 and administered by California State Parks Office of Grants and Local Services. For all the information on how to join in on the fun, you can call me, Ms. Trina, at 909-601-1566 or email me at shelton-moore_tr@sbcity.org. Space is limited, so register now.
And we're back. No score here at San Manuel Stadium between the Blackhawks and the Cowboys. As we head to the top of the second, Fabella and Fanazzo, your pitching matchup today, looking strong early on through the first frame. And leading things off here for the Blackhawks will be number 13, Jacob Cook. He'll get it cracking for CV. And first strike from Fabella. Fabella, the lefty, trying to go to the outside, just misses 1-1. Fabella likes to work quick. Outside, that one misses. 2-1 the count. Fabella. Now 3-1 to Cook. Hole up and let him cook with a 3-1 count. He might be. The pitch across the plate in for a strike. That'll bring it to a full count. The pitch. Outside, and another walk here for Citrus Valley, their second of the game. So just like the first inning, able to get a man aboard. That'll bring up Cole West. Number 12 from the left side. Blackhawks with the runner on first. Fabella set, fires. And can't get the inside corner, ball one. The pitch to West. That one's in for a strike. One and one the count, Fabella's ready. 2-1. Two balls, one strike to West. Fouls it up and out. 2-2 the count. The pitch from Fabella, no. He goes back over to first. Keeping an eye on Cook. West at the plate. 2-2. The offering inside. Oh, they're going to say it hit him. So he'll take his free pass, and Cook will advance down to second. So now a couple runners on for the Blackhawks. Nobody out here in the top of the second inning. Things got interesting all of a sudden here. Runners on first and second for CV. See if they can do anything here with nobody out. Laying down the bunts, Ryan Rossi. He does his job, and the runners will advance to second and third, so he gets the job done. He did exactly what he was supposed to do. So now two runners in scoring position for the Blackhawks with only one out. And that'll bring up number 21, John McKee. McKee trying to come through here for the Blackhawks. The pitch from Fabella up the middle and bobbled. That'll bring home a run for Citrus Valley. So now runners on the corners. The run is good. And the Blackhawks take the early lead. As we update the IEMG scoreboard for the first time today, 1-0 Blackhawks. Nathan Castillo digs in. Castillo lays down the bunt. It'll bounce and trickle foul. Castillo steps back into the box, ready to rock and roll here. The pitch fouls it away. Things were looking good for Fabella. Couple walks, though, put runners on base for the Blackhawks, and they're able to push one across and not done yet. That one to right center field. That one's going to be caught. The throw to the plate is not going to be in time. That'll bring home another run for Citrus Valley. So Castillo gets the job done, bringing home West. And it's now 2-0 CV. A couple early runs here in the second inning to spot the starter, Cade Finazzo, with a little bit of cushion as he will head back out to the bump in a moment. But two down here now in the top of the second. CV still with a runner on. Two zip Citrus Valley. Back to the top of the order, Angel Perez. Left center field. Diving, can't make the play. And now CV with runners on the corners again with two outs. And Keaton Nato is going to step up to the plate for CV. Try to do a little bit more damage here in the top of the second inning. A little bit of a mound visit. As we mentioned, things were looking good for Fabella, but a couple walks got him in a jam. And the Blackhawks able to make him pay. Runners on the corners, two outs. Nato at the plate. The pitch from Fabella. Pops it up high. The second baseman will handle it, but not before the Blackhawks get two runs here in the second inning. And they take a 2-0 lead here at the County Clash. We'll take a quick break on IEMG, and we will be right back.
I'm Stephanie with Community and Economic Development. Are you interested in housing for all residents, businesses that serve community needs, safe parks, or the overall quality of life for you and your neighbors? If so, now's the time to get involved. San Bernardino 2050 is a major planning initiative led by the City of San Bernardino that involves an update to the general plan. The general plan is a long-range plan that sets goals and policies for how San Bernardino will look in the year 2050. We will be hosting a series of upcoming workshops in each ward. These workshops will be held on different days where you can help us identify areas in which new housing, businesses, industries, parks and open spaces, and other uses should be located. Now's the time to make your voice heard, and it's an opportunity for you to change the future of your city. I'm Stephanie Sanchez, encouraging you to visit futuresb2050.com and learn how you can participate.
Welcome back to San Manuel Stadium, home of your Inland Empire 66ers. Quick plug for our friends here at the 66ers because it's almost time for their season as well. They've got Fan Fest coming up on April 2nd, 5 p.m., absolutely free right here at the stadium. So you can get up close and personal with your favorite 66ers, proud affiliate of the Angels, of course. So that's April 2nd. So that's right around the corner. Pro baseball almost back here in San Bernardino. It's always a good time out here. Love the 66ers. Even if you're not a baseball fan, I guarantee you're going to have a good time out here. Great food. The mascots are hilarious. Everybody loves Bernie. Slick, too, especially Bernie. That one's popped straight behind. Cade Finazzo, the pitch to number 42, Jean-Pierre Hurd, old JP. Like Finazzo's ready. That one's popped up and out of play once again. I don't know if Hurd has a nickname, but if they don't call him the Big Hurd, I think that's a missed opportunity. Remember the old Big Hurd? One of my favorite players, that was my heyday, Frank Thomas of the White Sox, the Big Hurd. See what the Big Hurd has going on here. 2-2 the count versus Finazzo. The pitch is going to miss, full count. Two zip Citrus Valley. Got a couple here in the second inning. That one fouled straight back right over our head. Finazzo's ready to deal. The pitch to Hurd. Got him. Nice strikeout there by Finazzo. That'll bring number 20, Matt Basurto, to the plate for the Cowboys. First pitch to Basurto. One and oh the count. Like Fabella, Finazzo works pretty quickly. Back onto the bump, ready to rock and roll. Like it. Basurto tries to check his swing. It's a strike regardless. 2-1 the count to Basurto. Basurto fouls it back into the stands. In a section where there's not a lot of fans, so no harm, no foul. 2-2 the count to Basurto. The pitch from Fanazzo. High and inside. That one's going to miss. Full count. Payoff pitch. Misses. Basurto draws the walk. Well, like the Blackhawks in the top of the second, they got a couple walks to get a couple runners on board, and we saw them turn that into a couple runs to take this 2-0 lead. Cajon trying to do the same here in the bottom half of the frame. That'll bring up Jaden Carpenter. Pitch to Carpenter in for a strike. 0-1 the count. That one's just going to miss. 1-1. The pitch to Carpenter. 2-1 the count. And a timeout called on the field. In fact, John Austin, the head coach of the Blackhawks, coming out to talk to his guy, Cade Fanazzo. This could potentially be a big inning for the Cowboys. If Fanazzo continues to struggle with a little bit of his command. Both pitchers, Fabella and Fanazzo, looked great to start, but a couple of walks was the undoing for Fabella in the top of the second. Now Fanazzo trying to avoid the same thing here. Carpenter getting ready to step back in. Throw back over to first. Basurto over at first. He drew the walk to lead off the inning. Now we've got Carpenter at the plate against Fanazzo running on the play. And Basurto is in safely as the throw gets away. Oh, I think they're going to say Basurto is out. Are they sent him, they sent him back to first. So Carpenter is out, but Basurto is sent back to first. That'll bring up Anthony Casares for the Cowboys. Now the sun's starting to peek out. Swing and a miss, 0-2 the count. With two outs, so Fanazzo one strike away from preventing any sort of a Cajon rally here. I know it's early in the second inning, but you never know. Over to third, the throw across the diamond is in time. Out number three. So we move to the third inning. And the Citrus Valley Blackhawks with a 2-0 lead here at the County Clash. We'll be right back here on IEMG.
Hello, this is Chris Watson from Animal Services for the City of San Bernardino. I'm here to remind you that the state requires all animals adopted or redeemed from a shelter or rescue organization to be microchipped. Microchipped pets have a better chance of being reunited with their families if they become lost or stolen. They also provide current information for our animal services staff to return them back to their rightful homes. In the long run, microchipping can really reduce the number of animals impounded, as well as the cost for the owner to retrieve their pet. Microchipping for animals impounded at our facility is $20, and microchipping owned pets by appointment at the shelter is $25. For further information on microchipping and to schedule an appointment, please call SB Direct at area code 909-384-7272. Once again, this is Chris Watson from Animal Services for the City of San Bernardino. Let's all do our part to get our pets back home swiftly and safely. Thank you for watching.
Welcome back to San Manuel Stadium. Ominous skies. Actually, it looks, I think, worse than it actually is, because here and inside the stadium, it looks pretty good. The sun is out. Actually seeing some shadows on the ground. So, but yeah, it looks ominous out there with the clouds, but the sun is beginning to peek through. The first game today between Redlands and Yucaipa was pretty wet, actually, but they got the game in, which is the good news. So we move to the top of the third inning. At the plate for Citrus Valley, Matt Blind. The pitch to Blind. Foul to the right side. Looks like Fabella's ready. The pitch, Blind pops it up into the infield. And there's out number one. That'll bring up Seeley again for the Blackhawks as they make their way through the lineup for a second time. First pitch inside to Seeley. Bernie doing Bernie things. That one's going to miss. 2-0 the count. One fouled away. Looks like Bernie's taking a little bit of a cat nap here in the top of the third inning with the Blackhawks up 2-0. The pitch from Fabella. That one's going to get through the left side. Seeley's on board for the Blackhawks. So one out here in the top of the third. CV with another man on. And up at the plate, Jacob Cook. That one's going to miss. Two balls, no strikes to Cook. That one's going to be in for a strike for Fabella. The pitch to Cook. Hits it hard to the left side. It's going to fall in for a base hit. So another single here by the Blackhawks, and they've got two runners on with only one out. That'll bring up Cole West. Runners on first and second for CV. Cole West from the left side. First pitch to West. It is a strike. Oh, and one the count to West. That one's going to be outside. Two zip Citrus Valley here in the top of the third. The pitch to West rips it to right field. Bobbled out there in right. Play at the plate, and he's safe. Another run for the Blackhawks, and they go up 3-0. RBI base hit by West. Nice clean hit by West to right field, no doubt about it. That brings home Seeley for the third run of the game. Now the sun really coming through here at San Manuel Stadium. Looks like a different ballpark the way we started this one. Now Ryan Rossi comes to the plate. Still two runners on, only one out. The Blackhawks are back at it again. That one to the right side. Going home with it and charging home and scoring for the Blackhawks. Number 13, Jacob Cook. Slam dunk for CV as they go up 4-0. Nice piece of running there by Cook. And another one for the Blackhawks. So two in the second, two more now in the third, and they're not done yet. They still got a runner in scoring position. Four nothing Citrus Valley. John McKee at the plate. Fabella steps off the mound. One and oh to McKee. Swing and a miss. One and one the count. Fabella. Swing and a miss. It's going to be one and two to McKee. The Blackhawks trying to get their first CBL win of the season, coming in at 0-2. The pitch to McKee to short. Over to first, and there's out number three, but not before Citrus Valley gets two more here in the third inning as they build a 4-0 lead here at the County Clash. Another quick break here on IEMG, and then it's back with the bottom of the third. Here come the Cowboys.
Ready to see changes within the City of San Bernardino Park System? This is your chance to provide your input by completing our Parks Master Plan Survey. You can help our park systems and recreational programs become the standard of excellence. We are committed to engaging our community and rebuilding the trust throughout the city so that our residents can feel safe and free to come to any of our parks, facilities, or events. You're going to ask, what is a Parks Master Plan? A master plan is a roadmap and a shared vision for the future of parks, recreation, and community services, and it's shaped by community values, unmet needs, and evolving demographics and trends. How does this affect me? From property values to economic impact and rebuilding a sense of community pride, Parks and Recreation provides tremendous benefits to the city of San Bernardino. The city would like your input to help determine park, facility, and recreation priorities for your community. Parks and recreation facilities contribute significantly to the quality of life in the city of San Bernardino, and your opinions and input is really important. We ask that you please complete the survey at www.mysbparks.com and help us become the best standard of excellence that we've seen in the city. Thank you.
Bottom of the third. Welcome back, everybody. Four Zip Citrus Valley. Jordan Salazar leading things off for the Cowboys. Searching not only for their first run in the game, but also their first hit in the game. That one's going to miss. 2-0 the count. Salazar. 3-0 the count. So three straight pitches, three straight balls to Salazar. He'll take the free pass, but let's see. This one should be right across the plate. No, it's going to miss. Salazar's going to head down to first. And that's going to take us right back to the top of the order for the Cowboys, Reinbolt. See if Dominic Reinbolt can get something going here for Cajon. The first pitch to Reinbolt, in for a strike. Pitch, Reinbolt fouls it back. Finazzo's ready. That one's outside. Pitch from Finazzo. That one's high. 2-2 the count to Reinbolt. Finazzo. The pitch. Little flare to the right side. Is that one fair? I think it was a fair ball. We had a little camera issue there, but it was a little flare to right field, right along the line. They called it fair, so now Cajon's got two runners on board with nobody out. Gavin Garcia steps in from the left side. That one's going to get away, running on the play. Salazar in safely at third. So now runners on the corners with nobody out for Cajon. Garcia looking to capitalize. And a real pickle, Reinbolt between first and second. The runner coming home is Salazar. And he's going to be in safely for Cajon's first run of the game. Reinbolt is out at second, but that brings home a run for the Cowboys. So now back to Garcia. 1-0 the count to Garcia. As we update the IEMG scoreboard. 4-1 game. Blackhawks are going to meet on the mound again. Nice-sized crowd here at San Manuel Stadium. It stopped raining, so that's all good. A little bit cold, but not bad at all. Looks like the home plate umpire is going to break up the mound visit, although head coach John Austin wasn't happy about something. Four to one, Citrus Valley on top. So here we go. The pitch to Garcia, that one's going to miss. 3-0 the count. Finazzo quickly winds up, lets it fire. And the walk. Four straight balls to Garcia, and he's on board down at first. And that'll bring up number 15 for the Cowboys, Ryan Contreras, the team's top hitter. First pitch to Contreras, a strike. Finazzo the pitch. 1-1. Oh, that one's hit solidly to left center field. Garcia is in at third, standing up. On the big base hit by Ryan Contreras. So the Cowboys got something going on. They've already got one across the plate. Now looking for more. That'll bring up the big herd. Marcus McQueen. Finazzo steps off, looks the runners back. Cajon's got runners on the corners right now. Only one out. The pitch to McQueen's going to miss. Starts him out with a ball, 1-0. Two and oh the count. McQueen takes a big cut, swings right through it. There's Garcia down at third for the Cowboys. McQueen shows bunt, fouls it straight back, so it's going to be 2-2 the count. Two Two balls, two strikes. The pitch to McQueen. It's going to miss. Full count. Finazzo comes inside, and that one's going to miss. Cade Finazzo walks McQueen. And here comes the big herd. So bases loaded. One out. And Jean-Pierre Herd comes to the plate. Herd fouls, pops it up into foul ground. McKee is there, but so is the catcher who makes the second out of the inning. So that was a big out here for the Blackhawks. Now the Cajon Cowboys are down to their final out here in the bottom of the third. They still have the bases loaded. Now it's going to be up to Matt Basurto to get it popping here for the Cowboys. The first pitch to Basurto. Strike. Finazzo trying to limit the damage here. The Cowboys have one run here in the frame. Looking for more. Basurto, big drive to left field. It's going to be over the left fielder's head. That's going to bring in a couple runs for the Cowboys. And Cajon gets a couple more back on the big hit from Basurto. Makes it a 4-3 game. Yeah, Basurto hit that ball hard. Matt Basurto makes it a 4-3 ball game here in the bottom of the third inning. That'll bring up Jaden Carpenter. He's got two runners in scoring position with two gone here in the bottom of the third. Nice two-out base knock for Basurto. That'll bring up Carpenter. Finazzo starts out Carpenter with a strike. The pitch, Carpenter swinging a miss. 0-2 the count. There's Basurto back at second. Big double to drive in two. It's been the big hit for Cajon in this one. Oh, Carpenter rips one to left, but right at the left fielder for out number three, but he got a hold of that one. Cajon gets three runs here in the third inning, and all of a sudden we've got ourselves a one-run game again here at the County Clash. It's 4-3 Citrus Valley as we move to the fourth here live on IEMG.
Now that school is back in session, the San Bernardino Public Library is supporting online learners in a couple of ways. With BrainFuse Live Homework Help, BrainFuse offers kindergarten through grade 12, college, and adult learners assistance with various subjects. Experts via live chat from 1 p.m. to 10 p.m. daily, except major holidays. BrainFuse can be accessed through the library's website at www.sbpl.org. BrainFuse offers help with SATs, ACTs, and GED test prep. A writing lab is also available. BrainFuse is also available in Spanish. You will need a San Bernardino Public Library card to log in. If you do not already have one, you can sign up online for a free library card at the library's website at www.sbpl.org or go directly to http://catalog.sbpl.org:8086/online/ borrowerregistration.html. Please allow up to a full working day for your library card to be activated.
And welcome back to San Manuel Stadium. They're actually throwing hot dogs into the crowd right now. What's not to love about coming out to the County Clash? Great baseball, flying hot dogs. It's all good. And delicious. Isaac Fabella versus Nathan Castillo to open up the top of the fourth. That one's going to miss 2-0. There's the lefty, Fabella. Fires it in. That one's going to miss 2. 3-0 the count. The pitch to Castillo's going to miss. Ball 4. Castillo heads down to first. That's going to bring up Angel Perez. So it's kind of a tough walk right there, walking the number 9 batter. Because now you're going to go back to the top of the order, and now Citrus Valley's got a runner on. Head coach Robert Grande sharing, I'm sure pearls of wisdom with Fabella and the rest of the infield. There's nobody up in the bullpen right now for Cajon. Angel Perez coming up for Citrus Valley here on the top of the fourth, a 4-3 ball game. The pitch to Perez. Throw down to first. Yeah, it actually looks sunny here. Who would have thought? 0-1 the count. That one is also in for a strike. So 0-2. Fabella going right at Perez. The pitch from Fabella. That one will miss. 1-2. Well, the sun peeks out for a moment, then it goes and hides again. The pitch to Perez outside. Fabella is ready. The pitch, swing and a miss. Big strikeout for Fabella. That'll bring up number 3, Keaton Nato. First pitch to Nato. Strike 1. Don't forget about the runner down at first. That one to Nato is going to miss 1-1 the count. Fabella continuing to work very quickly on the bump. That one steps on second. The throw over to first is in time. Got him. Dominic Reinbolt. And Citrus Valley comes up empty here in the top of the fourth. We move to the bottom of the fourth on IEMG. Stick with us. We'll be right back.
Hey friends, guess what? Back to Nature is now registering for overnight camp at YMCA Camp Elk. Youth ages 7 to 12 will attend camp from June 10th to June 14th. Teenagers 13 to 17 will attend camp from June 24th to 28th. You don't want to miss out on all the fun. There will be archery, rock wall climbing, improv, arts and crafts, swimming, campfires, and stargazing. This program is funded by the Outdoor Equity Grant Program, created through AB 209 and administered by California State Parks Office of Grants and Local Services. For all the information on how to join in on the fun, you can call me, Ms. Trina, at 909-601-1566 or email me at shelton-moore_tr@sbcity.org. Space is limited, so register now.
Welcome back, everybody. We head to the bottom of the fourth. 4-3, Blackhawks on top. It's been a fun one here at the County Clash, a little back and forth. Cade Finazzo still out there on the bump for Citrus Valley as we go to bottom of four. As I mentioned, leading things off will be Anthony Casares for the Cowboys. Congrats to head coach Ralph Grajeda in Yucaipa, a 3-0 winner against Redlands in the first game of the County Clash earlier today. We've got Redlands East Valley versus Beaumont in the nightcap coming up at 7 o'clock. I'm going to guess there's some Rev people already here because I see little spots of red dotted throughout the crowd. That one knocked down at third. The throw to first. Oh, is in time. What a play. Number 13, Jacob Cook. Knocked it down, and a big throw across the diamond was just in time. Good job by Cook. Looks like Coach Grande is going to talk to the umpire as they play Frozen's Let It Go. I'm sure that's not by accident. All right, so one out here in the bottom of the fourth. Finazzo, first pitch inside. They're going to say it hit Jordan Salazar. So he'll head down to first. If my memory serves me correctly, I think Salazar also walked in his first at-bat. Just finding ways to get on board. All right, that's going to bring up Dominic Reinbolt, the leadoff man for the Cowboys. The pitch. Reinbolt to left field. Left center field. The center fielder comes in and makes the catch for out number two. That'll bring up Gavin Garcia. Garcia shows bunt. Running is Salazar, and he's in easily. The ball goes away. Now he's heading down to third. Salazar slides in. He's safe there, too. Looks like they're going to hold him up at third. Couple wild throws made that interesting. You thought for a moment Salazar might take a chance and head for home. Decided not to. Now the Cowboys have a runner on third with two gone. The pitch to Garcia, swing and a miss, 1-1. There's Salazar down at third, trying to manufacture a run here for the Cowboys. The pitch to Garcia. I think he got a piece of it. Nonetheless, it's a strike. 1-2 the count. One and two, Fanazzo, ready to go. The pitch, got him. Strike three for Fanazzo. So the Cowboys will strand Salazar at third. And it's a 4-3 ball game here at the County Clash. We'll be right back here on IEMG. Rain, rain, stay away.
Ready to see changes within the City of San Bernardino Park System? This is your chance to provide your input by completing our Parks Master Plan Survey. You can help our park systems and recreational programs become the standard of excellence. We are committed to engaging our community and rebuilding the trust throughout the city so that our residents can feel safe and free to come to any of our parks, facilities, or events. You're going to ask, what is a Parks Master Plan? A master plan is a roadmap and a shared vision for the future of parks, recreation, and community services, and it's shaped by community values, unmet needs, and evolving demographics and trends. How does this affect me? From property values to economic impact and rebuilding a sense of community pride, Parks and Recreation provides tremendous benefits to the City of San Bernardino. The city would like your input to help determine park, facility, and recreation priorities for your community. Parks and recreation facilities contribute significantly to the quality of life in the City of San Bernardino, and your opinions and input is really important. We ask that you please complete the survey at www.mysbparks.com and help us become the best standard of excellence that we've seen in the city. Thank you.
Let's go to the fifth inning. 4-3, Citrus Valley up by one here at the County Clash. A big shout out to the 66ers who always do just a great job here. What a great showcase for high school baseball here. They've been doing this for years, and this will be the first of three County Clash events here at San Manuel Stadium. The next one coming up on March 30th. I don't have the schedule in front of me, but I know ACA is going to be playing Linfield Christian in that County Clash. And there'll be another one on April 13th. And as I mentioned in our pregame show, we'll have Ontario Christian versus Aquinas live as the Blackhawks' Matt Blind singles to get on board. That'll bring up number five, Robert Seeley.
Can you put us on the screen?
Oh, we got a request to get on the screen. So hold on 1 second, guys. Hold on. I'll tell you when you're going to be on. Let's wait after this pitch. We got a couple young fans down here enjoying some ice cream. That one's popped up to shallow left center field for the out. All right, guys, here's your chance. You're live right now. You're too scared. Just wave. Who are you guys rooting for, the Cowboys or the Blackhawks? Blackhawks? You want the Blackhawks to win? All right, so one out here. That one's going to be inside. So they got Seeley. That'll bring up Jacob Cook. Still got a runner on here for CV with one out. Oh, they got him in a rundown, a real pickle. Reinbolt applies the tag, and there's out number two. So a nice pickoff move by Fabella. Got him in that pickle. Easy out number two. Good job by Reinbolt as well. Two gone here in the top of the fifth. One and one the count. Swing and a miss on Cook. Now it's 1-2. The pitch to Cook. Grounds it to first. Hustling over. Is he in time? He's not. Good try by Basurto. Could not get there in time. Nice hustle play by Cook. So Cook's on first with two outs here. And here comes Coach Grande again. Looking for an explanation. And cue up the frozen Let It Go music. The 66ers have a good sense of humor, to say the least, here. Have a lot of fun. Stepping up from the left side, it's Cole West for the Blackhawks. Two out here in the top of five. The pitch into Cole West. 1-1 the count. It's never too cold for ice cream. That pitch fouled away. So we'll keep it here on this kid. Getting his ice cream. I'm one of those guys too. It could be freezing out. It could be super cold, but I prefer a cold drink or an ice cream. The single to left center field. And now two runners on board for Citrus Valley. So hold on, we are not done yet. Nice piece of hitting by Cole West. That'll bring up Ryan Rossi. Fabella's ready. Trying to work out of this inning. Base hit to left field. The runner coming around third, and he is safe. Now we got a couple situations here between first and second to throw home, and another run scores for the Blackhawks. They get two. What a weird sequence there. The clean base hit brought in one, and then the pickle between first and second brings in another. Two more for the Blackhawks. A two-out rally here. Makes it a 6-3 game. Citrus Valley. They still have a runner in scoring position down at second. The pitch from Fabella. That one's going to be in for a strike. Facing John McKee. Key swing and a miss. Quickly 0-2. Ryan Rossi coming up with a big base knock. Brought in a couple. Top of the fifth is over, but not before Citrus Valley pushes across a couple more runs here. Thanks to Ryan Rossi. We'll take a quick break on IEMG. Then it's right back to San Manuel Stadium, the County Clash.
Hello, this is Chris Watson from Animal Services for the City of San Bernardino. I'm here to remind you that the state requires all animals adopted or redeemed from a shelter or rescue organization to be microchipped. Microchipped pets have a better chance of being reunited with their families if they become lost or stolen. They also provide current information for our animal services staff to return them back to their rightful homes. In the long run, microchipping can really reduce the number of animals impounded as well as the cost for the owner to retrieve their pet. Microchipping for animals impounded at our facility is $20, and microchipping owned pets by appointment at the shelter is $25. For further information on microchipping and to schedule an appointment, please call SB Direct at area code 909-384-7272. Once again, this is Chris Watson from Animal Services for the City of San Bernardino. Let's all do our part to get our pets back home swiftly and safely. Thank you for watching.
Welcome back. Bottom of the fifth we go. The Cowboys pulled it within a one-run game, but CV in the top half of this frame pushed across two more to extend their lead to 6-3 here at the County Clash. Bottom of five. Cade Fanazzo back out there on the bump. Now with a little bit of a cushion to work with. See if he takes advantage of that. The first pitch to number 15, Ryan Contreras. Red hot right now for the Cowboys. Hitting well over 400 on the season. That one's in for a strike. 1-1 the count to Contreras. Contreras swinging a miss. 1-2. There's old Bernie doing Bernie things. Contreras will watch that one. 2-2. The pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike three. So Contreras goes down swinging, and that'll bring up number six, Marcus McQueen. The first pitch, Fanazzo to McQueen. Fouled out to the right side. Bernie once again. The pitch to McQueen, that one's going to miss. And more snacks coming your way. The pitch from Fanazzo to McQueen. And for a strike, 1-2 the count. Fanazzo. The pitch, swing and a miss, another K. Back-to-back strikeouts for Fanazzo. He's got it locked in right now. So two gone here in the bottom of the fifth inning. That'll bring up Hurd. The first pitch to Hurd. And first strike, Fanazzo being pretty aggressive here in this inning. Maybe it's because he's got a three-run lead to work with, but like his stuff right now. That one's going to miss 1-1, the count to Hurd. That one's in for a strike. Lots of good snacks here at San Manuel Stadium. Almost dinner time, if you ask me. The pitch to Hurd's going to miss 2-2 the count. A lot of jalapenos. The pitch from Fanazzo to Hurd outside. Got him. Fanazzo strikes out the side here in the fifth inning as CV will take a three-run lead as we move to the sixth. We'll be right back here on IEMG, the County Clash, live.
Hey friends, guess what? Back to Nature is now registering for overnight camp at YMCA Camp Elk. Youth ages 7 to 12 will attend camp from June 10th to June 14th. Teenagers 13 to 17 will attend camp from June 24th to 28th. You don't want to miss out on all the fun. There will be archery, rock wall climbing, improv, arts and crafts, swimming, campfires, and stargazing. This program is funded by the Outdoor Equity Grant Program, created through AB 209 and administered by California State Parks, Office of Grants and Local Services. For all the information on how to join in on the fun, you can call me, Miss Trina, at 909-601-1566 or email me at shelton-moore_tr@sbcity.org. Space is limited, so register now.
And we're back here, top of the, well, sixth inning here. We're moving along now. We might be done by 6 o'clock if we don't watch it. Fabella still out there. He's facing Nathan Castillo to open up the top of the sixth. There's Fabella. The pitch to the right side and foul. Facing Castillo. 2-1 the count. 2 balls, 1 strike. Swing and a miss. 2-2 to Castillo. Bella's ready. The pitch fouled hard down the left side. Looks like Cajon's got a man up in the bullpen getting warmed up. See how much longer Fabella will stay out there. Maybe it depends on how this inning goes. To the right side, and that's going to be slapped through and in for a base hit for Castillo. So Castillo's on board, and you can cue up that Timmy trumpet. And here comes head coach Robert Grande, and he might be making his move right here. And it looks like Fabella's day is coming to a close. Gave up 6 runs on 9 hits. Had a couple strikeouts. Coming in relief here for the Cowboys in the sixth inning with no outs is number 17, Richard Sievers. Sievers getting loose as he's about to tackle the Citrus Valley lineup, which is, I believe, either at the top of the order or about to go to the top of the order. It looks like, yeah, Perez is coming up, so they're back to the leadoff man. So this is going to be a tough part of the lineup to get through for Sievers. We'll see what kind of stuff he's got as he takes over for Fabella. Hats off to Fabella, really grinded it out against a good Blackhawks team. So it'll be Angel Perez coming up to the plate for Citrus Valley. They're up 6-3. They've got a runner on first and nobody out here in the top of the sixth inning. Perez digs in from the left side. Here we go. First pitch from Severs. In for a strike. Owen won the count. That one will miss. One ball, one strike. Severs the pitch. 2-1. Ryan Bolt over to first. Safe. So they get the force out at second. But the runner's on at first, and that'll bring up Keegan Nato. Still a runner on first for the Blackhawks. 6-3 ball game. The first pitch to Nato. Bunt's foul. Perez will head back down to first. Owen won the count to Nato. Swing and a miss, 0-2. Throw over to first to Basurto. Keep Perez honest over there. Back over to first. Severs keeping a close eye on the leadoff man for the Blackhawks, Perez. The pitch to Nato called strike three. So a big punch out for Severs. Second out of the inning. That'll bring up number six, Matt Bline. The pitch from Severs to Bline in for a strike. The offering from Severs. Oh, that's going to catch the outside quickly. 0-2. Blind's going to have to battle back in this count. Don't forget about Perez over at first. Here goes Severs. Perez is running. Oh, it's going to be close. Safe. Perez barely gets in there, but he does in time. So a runner in scoring position now for Blind at the plate. Looking at a 1-2 count. One ball, two strikes. Severs. It's going to miss high. 2-2 the count. There's Perez down at second. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Severs versus Bline. The pitch to Bline. That one's going to just miss. Full count. Oh, On deck is Robert Seeley. If we get that far, two out here in the top of the sixth. The pitch from Seavers. Payoff pitch, strike three. So Seavers comes in and gets a couple big strikeouts to keep it a 6-3 game. We're going to take a quick break here on IEMG. When we come back, we'll see if the Cowboys can start down the comeback trail here at the County Clash.
Ready to see changes within the City of San Bernardino Park System? This is your chance to provide your input by completing our Parks Master Plan Survey. You can help our park systems and recreational programs become the standard of excellence. We are committed to engaging our community and rebuilding the trust throughout the city so that our residents can feel safe and free to come to any of our parks, facilities, or events. You're going to ask, what is a Parks Master Plan? A master plan is a roadmap and a shared vision for the future of parks, recreation, and community services, and it's shaped by community values, unmet needs, and evolving demographics and trends. How does this affect me? From property values to economic impact and rebuilding a sense of community pride, Parks and Recreation provides tremendous benefits to the City of San Bernardino. The city would like your input to help determine park, facility, and recreation priorities for your community. Parks and recreation facilities contribute significantly to the quality of life in the City of San Bernardino, and your opinions and input is really important. We ask that you please complete the survey at www.mysbparks.com and help us become the best standard of excellence that we've seen in the city. Thank you.
Welcome back, everybody. Bottom of the sixth. Cowboys down by three. Leading things off will be Matt Basurto. You'll remember Basurto had that big base knock, a two-run double in the third inning for Cajon to make it a 6-3. Well, actually, at the time, it was a 4-3 game. One and one the count. Finazzo to Basurto to short. Throw over to first. Gets away. So Basurto is on board. So the Cowboys not done yet. Going down. Not going down without a fight, I should say. That'll bring up Jaden Carpenter. May have a change here as head coach Robert Grande is talking to the old blue, the home plate umpire. Looks like we're going to have a pinch runner for Matt Basurto. It's going to be number 8, Riley Wynn. So I would presume that Riley's going to bring a little bit of extra speed on the base path here for the Cowboys. Looking to generate some runs here, trailing by 3 in the bottom of the 6th. So time running out here for Cajon. The pitch to Carpenter misses from Finazzo. That one's in for a strike. Well, we had the sun, and apparently the clouds have come back in. Overcast once again here at San Manuel Stadium. Going back to first is Riley Wynn. Could be a chilly nightcap for Redlands East Valley and Beaumont. In fact, I know it is. Carpenter's going to look at that one. Comes across the plate in for a strike. 2-2. The pitch. Carpenter hits this one hard to left field. The left fielder with plenty of time to get underneath it. That was Matt Bline out there in left. Carpenter gave it a ride. But a big spacious ballpark here. Bline, plenty of time to get underneath that ball. So one out here in the bottom of the sixth. That'll bring up Anthony Casares. The first pitch to Casares. And for a strike. That one is going to miss 1-1. Here's Casares. Riley went down at first. One out here in the bottom of the sixth. The pitcher in Fanazzo gets away. There goes Wynn. Takes a big turn. And he'll retreat back to second, but he does pick up an extra base here. Two balls, one strike to Casares. Oh, that one's going to fall in for a strike. 2-2. Fanazzo, the offering. Oh, and he's going to hit Casares. Casares is hurting here, but he's going to make his way down to first. Hopefully Casares is okay, holding his arm. So now the Cowboys have two runners on at first and second with one out, and the tying run is going to come up to the plate. That's Jordan Salazar. Looks like Casares is going to come out of the game as he's holding his arm. So we will have a pinch runner. That's going to be Efren Escobedo. There's Efren. Where's number zero? So Escobedo at first and Wynn down at second. So a couple pinch runners in for Cajon right now. And now batting's going to be Jordan Salazar. He's got on board a couple times in this game via walk. But now he represents the tying run. First pitch to Salazar. It's a strike from Fanazzo. The pitch. Oh, that one's getting a little high, a little outside, but it caught the corner. 0-2. Fanazzo trying to get ahead of Salazar. There's Wynn out there at second. Fanazzo takes a quick look at him, then fires towards the plate. He fouls it away. Citrus Valley with two runs in the second, two more in the third, and two more in the fifth to build this 6-3 lead. Two runners on. That one to left field. Bline is underneath it for the second out.
Now batting number 27, Dominic Reinhold.
That'll take us to the top of the order now for Cajon. Finazzo will face Dominic Reinbolt. You can see Citrus Valley head coach John Austin in the bottom right-hand corner talking with the home plate umpire. Two outs. Cajon has two runners on. And here comes Reinbolt. The pitch from Finazzo's in for a strike. Starts him out 0-1. The pitch high and inside on Reinbolt, 1-1 the count. The pitch, that one's outside. Sliding back in is Wynn at second. Six to three, Citrus Valley. 2-1, the pitch. Reinbolt goes to right center field with it, but coming in for out number three. So two runners on for the Cowboys, but they come up empty as we move to the seventh inning. Finazzo works out of it. And we'll take a quick break here on IEMG. We'll be right back.
Stephanie with Community and Economic Development. Are you interested in housing for all residents, businesses that serve community needs, safe parks, or the overall quality of life for you and your neighbors? If so, now's the time to get involved. San Bernardino 2050 is a major planning initiative led by the City of San Bernardino that involves an update to the general plan. The general plan is a long-range plan that sets goals and policies for how San Bernardino will look in the year 2050. We will be hosting a series of upcoming workshops in each ward. These workshops will be held on different days where you can help us identify areas in which new housing, businesses, industries, parks and open spaces, and other uses should be located. Now's the time to make your voice heard, and it's an opportunity for you to change the future of your city. I'm Stephanie Sanchez, encouraging you to visit futuresb2050.com and learn how you can participate.
Here we go, top of the seventh inning. Citrus Valley with one more chance to tack on maybe a couple more runs to feel real good about themselves going to the bottom of the seventh here at the County Clash. We appreciate you tuning in live on IEMG. If you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe to the IE Media Group YouTube channel. We would appreciate it. And here we go, top of the seventh action. Robert Seeley stepping up for the Blackhawks. 1-1 the count. as he faces Richard Sievers, who came in relief of Fabella in the sixth inning. Sievers did a great job, got a couple Ks. That one fouled away. Well, for Cajon in the bottom of the seventh, they'll have their 2, 3, and 4 hitters, I believe, coming up. Swing and a miss. Oh, I think they're going to say it hit Seeley, I think is what they're going to say. It looked like a swing and a miss, but must have got a piece of his hand. Yeah, he was signing that. I got a piece of his hand. It looks like we'll have a pinch runner. Charlie Pratt's going to come in. So now Sievers will have to deal with Pratt over there at first. So runner on for the Blackhawks here in the top of the seventh. The pitch from Sievers to number 13, Jacob Cook, is a ball. Sievers. Oh, big cut by Cook. 1-1. The pitch to Cook is high. 2-1 the count. Pitch from Sievers. That one will miss. 3-1 the count to number 13, Jacob Cook. Here's the pitch. That one's in. Full count coming up. See Beaumont down the right field line. I'm not sure what that move is. Reaching up into the air. I'm sure they do. It's a Beaumont thing, I suppose. I like it. Full count. Coming up, Sievers to Cook. Got a piece of it. The battle rages on. Three balls, two strikes, another payoff pitch coming up. Sievers and Cook. Cook and Sievers. That one's high. It's going to miss. Ball four. Cook heads down to first, and all of a sudden, the Blackhawks got something brewing. That'll bring up number 12, Cole West. Nobody out here in the top of the seventh. Two runners on. The pitch fouled away. Looks like a Shohei Ohtani jersey in the stands. Dodgers, not Angels. Owen won the count to Cole West. Pitches inside, it's going to get away. Runners will advance for the Blackhawks. So now they've got two runners in scoring position. Still nobody out. It was a nice and clean sixth inning for Severs when he stepped in. Did a really good job, but now he's in a jam. Two runners in scoring position, nobody out. Pitch to West, rips it to right field. It's going to fall in for a base hit. That's going to score a run. In fact, make it two. Two runs cross the plate. And two more for the Blackhawks here in the top of the seventh inning as they make it an 8-3 game. Big hit by Cole West. Hit that ball hard to right field. As we go back to the IEMG scoreboard, two more for CV to extend their lead to five. CV with eight runs on 10 hits. Still with a runner on second. That's Cole West. Big two-run base knock. Ryan Rossi at the plate for the Blackhawks. He had a big hit earlier in this game. Trying to do it again here for CV. The pitch. Oh, through the legs of the catcher. The runner will advance. Cole West down to third. And still nobody out here in the top of the seventh inning. Also, nobody up in the Cajon bullpen when you look down the left field line. Severs is going to have to work out of this one. The pitch to Rossi, ball four. So now runners on the corners for Citrus Valley. Looks like we'll have a mound visit by head coach Robert Grande. Blackhawks leading 8-3. They've got runners on the corners, nobody out, and mighty John McKee stepping up to the plate. Out here in the top of the seventh. The first pitch to McKee fouled back. Owen won the count to McKee. Severs, nice pitch inside. 0-2. Severs ready to rock and roll. The pitch to McKee. Got a piece of it. There's Redlands East Valley. They'll be in the black uniforms, it appears. A little bit of red on there as well. For the nightcap against Beaumont coming up. pitch to McKee. Turns on that one. Pulls it foul, but man, he really turned on it in a hurry. Still 0-2. Still alive. We got a McKee fan in the house. Let's pan down a little bit. My camera guy. Yeah, there you go, buddy. Number 21, McKee. The pitch coming up from Severs to McKee. That one's going to miss. 1-2, the count. One ball, two strikes. McKee's going to look at that one, and that is strike three. Good stuff there by Severs for the first out of the inning. And that'll bring up Nathan Castillo, number 14 for the Blackhawks. First pitch to Castillo, in for a ball. Eight-3 game. Runners going. Wisely not throwing down to second because there is a runner on third as well for Citrus Valley. So hold that runner at third. But now the Blackhawks with two runners in scoring position with only one out. And the base hit by Perez with only one out drives home another run for the Blackhawks. Pushes their lead to 9-3. Pitch in for a ball. Base is still loaded for the Blackhawks. Want to know the count. The pitch. 3-0 the count. Seavers will have to pitch a strike here. Three and oh. Seavers looking for a strike. Got it. 3-1. So 3-1 the count. Bases loaded. 9-3 game. That one fouled off. Citrus Valley on top by a score of 9-3 here at the County Clash. Bases loaded. Only one out. The pitch. That one's going to be right up the middle. Trying to turn two. It's got going to be in time, and one more run will score for Citrus Valley to make it a 10-3 game. So Citrus Valley does it again. The pitch. Now it's outside. The throw down to second is not in time. That pitch is going to get away. In comes another run. Makes it 11-3. Citrus Valley. So things falling apart here for Cajon. It was once a 4-3 ball game. But Citrus Valley tacking on some runs here to essentially put this one away. Citrus Valley on top, and drawing the walk is Matt Blind, as he'll head down to first. Still just two outs here. Jacob Cook is scheduled to hit. Let's see if we're going to have a pinch hitter here. Oh, it looks like Cook was on deck. Number two, Adrian Abarca, is coming out. It'll be Abarca coming up to the plate. There's head coach Robert Grande. Looks like we're going to have another pitching change. Seavers comes out of the game. And it'll be, well, it's going to be Marcus McQueen stepping in. An 11-3 ball game. Blackhawks up by 8 here in the final inning. McQueen's going to come into this game. Trying to limit the damage here, but might say the damage has already been done. Abarca will be coming up. So Abarca will come up to the plate, seeing his first at-bat of the night. Citrus Valley with 11 runs on 11 hits, 2 errors. Cajon just 3 hits for 3 runs and 1 error. All 3 of the Cowboy runs came in the bottom of the third inning, and at that point it was a 4-3 ball game. Anything could happen. The Blackhawks have since posted 7 more runs to essentially put this game out of reach. But who knows, maybe they'll make me eat my words and they'll have a comeback of the century coming up in the bottom of the 7th. But we're not done yet. I mean, Citrus Valley's got runners on the corners with 2 outs, and here comes Abarca. First pitch to Abarca. Some heat here from McQueen. Makes it 1-1. Pitch is high. That one's going to miss. 2-1 the count. That one got the outside. 2-2. Seems like every time McQueen throws, he loses his hat. Marcus McQueen. Full count. Full count on Abarca. Runners on the corners. McQueen is ready. The payoff pitch. To Abarca. It's going to miss. Bases loaded. And now that'll bring up Jacob Cook. Hole up, let him cook. We're going to see what's on the menu in just a second because he's got the bases loaded here. It's already been a 5-run 7th inning for Citrus Valley. Cook can add to that. There is 2 outs. McQueen just needs 1 more to get out of this inning. Good pitch to Cook, in for a strike, 1-1. The pitch, swing and a miss. One and two the count. Swings and misses for strike 3, but a 5-run 7th inning has given Citrus Valley an 11-3 lead. One more quick break here. When we come back, we go to the bottom of the 7th with the Cowboys.
Hey friends, guess what? Back to Nature is now registering for overnight camp at YMCA Camp Elk. Youth ages 7 to 12 will attend camp from June 10th to June 14th. Teenagers 13 to 17 will attend camp from June 24th to 28th. You don't want to miss out on all the fun. There will be archery, rock wall climbing, improv, arts and crafts, swimming, campfires, and stargazing. This program is funded by the Outdoor Equity Grant Program, created through AB 209 and administered by California State Parks Office of Grants and Local Services. For all the information on how to join in on the fun, you can call me, Ms. Trina, at 909-601-1566 or email me at shelton-moore_tr@sbcity.org. Space is limited, so register now.
And welcome back to San Manuel Stadium as we move to the bottom of the seventh. Cowboys trailing by eight. We've got the Simba cam going on here at San Manuel Stadium where you lift up your kid, you know, like Simba from the Lion King movie. One of my all-time favorites. I'd say an all-time classic. And now in to close things out for Citrus Valley, it's going to be number 13, Jacob Cook. Try to close out the win for Cade Finazzo. The Blackhawks three outs away from picking up their first CBL win of the season. Came in at 0-2 after a couple tough losses to a gritty Beaumont squad. In fact, Beaumont is getting loose over here. As we talked about the CBL race, I think every team feels like they've got a chance to be in the hunt for that CBL title. I mean, every team. Traditionally, I know Yucaipa and Rev and Citrus Valley, they've been tough to beat. But Beaumont, they're in the mix. You know Cajon's going to be tough. Redland's got some players. It's going to be a lot of fun. That one fouled up and out. Just saw Beaumont on the opposite side. There's Redlands East Valley getting loose. Gavin Garcia at the plate. The pitch to Garcia pulls it foul. Good swing on that one, though. Swing and a miss. Down goes Garcia. So one out here in the bottom of the seventh. It's going to bring number 15, Ryan Contreras, to the plate. First pitch is a strike. We've got one out here in the bottom of the seventh, the County Clash. -11.3. That offering from Cook sails high. Two balls, one strike to Ryan Contreras. Two and two the count. Starting to get a little dark in here. Two balls, two strikes to Contreras. Tries to hold back, and that is going to be a check swing, strike three. So two gone. The Cowboys down to their final out, and that'll bring up Marcus McQueen. First pitch to McQueen. In for a ball, 1-0 the count. Cook fires it in, 1-1. Oh, that one's going to miss. 2-1 the count. Cook throws it wide, 3-1 the count. Three balls, one strike to McQueen. Full count after that swing and a miss. Could be the final pitch of the ball game. The pitch from Cook hits McQueen. So McQueen's going to head down to first with two outs in this game. Or two outs here in the bottom of the seventh. One out left in this game, I should say. So runner down on first for the Cowboys as number 13, Jacob Cook, on the mound in relief for the Blackhawks, trying to close this one out. There's Cook on the bump. Pitch is inside. 2-0 the count. Two balls, no strike. That one's high. It's going to miss. Another walk. Another walk with two outs here in the bottom of the seventh. That'll bring up Matt Basurto. Basurto knocked in a couple runs earlier tonight. Head coach John Austin coming out to the hill to talk to Cook and the rest of the infield. It's probably like, guys, I got dinner reservations. Let's close this thing out. Why don't we wrap this thing up? Everybody's getting hungry around here. Here comes the home plate umpire to break it up. Break it up, guys. Uh-oh, we got a switch here. See what's going on. Carter Park is coming out. Oh, yeah, I think he's going to come in relief of Cook. Jacob Cook exits the game with two outs here in the bottom of the seventh. He came in to try to close things out and seal the deal. But it looks like Citrus Valley will turn to number 10, Carter Park, to secure their first CBL win of the year. It'll be Matt Basurto coming up for Cajon. Maybe it's the beginning of the greatest two-out rally we've ever seen. Down by eight, two outs. Or Carter Park might come in and throw one pitch and we'll be out of here. 11-3, Citrus Valley. Cajon down to its final out. It's taken a while. They just keep holding on. Cajon's been down to their final out for a while. Oh, looks like we're going to have a glove switch. I think that bright red glove is just too much. Looks like Park will take a couple more warm-up pitches because he was not up in the bullpen getting loose. He was in the dugout with the rest of the guys. I think they just assumed Cook was going to close this baby out. But now they'll turn to Park. Cajon with two runners on board. First and second with two outs here. Here's McQueen down at second. The pitch to Basurto is in for a strike. The pitch. Oh, great pitch by Park. 1-1. Two runners on for the Cowboys. Two outs. Popped up to left field. That is blind out and left, and that is the final out of the ball game. Citrus Valley is going to win this one by a final score of 11-3. So the Blackhawks pick up their first CBL win of the season. 11-3, the final score here at the County Clash. So congratulations to CV getting the win here. Our next live game here on IEMG will be another County Clash coming up on April 13th. It'll be Ontario Christian taking on Aquinas in Ambassador League play. That's April 13th, 7 p.m. right here live on IEMG. And if we can, a quick plug for FanFest coming up for the 66ers on April 2nd. So get a chance to come out to San Manuel Stadium and meet the 66ers a couple nights before they actually open play. They will open up the season on April 5th. But on April 2nd, you can come out to a free event here at San Manuel Stadium and meet the team. So that'll be a lot of fun. So you can check that out. Final score tonight from the County Clash. Citrus Valley gets the win, 11-3 against Cajon. My name is Pep Fernandez. We appreciate you tuning in, and we'll see you next time on IEMG. Good night, everybody.